OMG, it is finally Horizon Zero Dawn, a PlayStation exclusive that I have personally been looking forward to since E3 of last year. And here we have it, available finally, and we're going to play the first hour of this game. Now, we were given this game. Sony gave me a free copy of this game to review. I've been playing it for the last 2 weeks or so, but I'm going to start from the beginning. So the only thing you're not going to see on this episode of OMG Hits is the actual introduction movie that happens. There's quite a lengthy cinematic. We're going to skip over that and dive right into the beginning of the game when the main character of Aloy is just like 6 years old. Okay, it's going to jump in, cool. And we're going to show, you know, a little bit about her and how the game starts. So, Tico, how about yourself? You're not a PlayStation guy.
I'm not a PlayStation guy, but this game does look fantastic. I have seen your gushing on Facebook.
I have been doing nothing but gushing for like a week now since I could talk about it.
When I originally saw the teaser trailer for this, it looks fantastic. From everything I've heard, it holds up to what people were expecting. So I'm excited to see what this is going to be like, and I will most likely be picking this up next week and actually playing something on the PlayStation.
All right, well, let's jump into it then, into Horizon Zero Dawn.
All right.
So there's our 6 years later. So.
After the loading screen.
After a lengthy loading screen, yes. So what we know up to this point from the intro movie is that Aloy and her guardian, Rost, are what they call exiles. They've been exiled from their clan for reasons unknown. And ooh, as an exile, you're not allowed to... The people in the tribe are not allowed to talk to you. It's kind of illegal to...
That's what exiling is. You know...
So just to give you some reference as to why she's looking in and looking a little jealous.
Well done, that's a good boy. Children, come with me. She's an outcast to be shunned.
They take their shunning seriously.
Yeah. But look at the character designs. They look so real. They look incredible. Just those details.
You get less of that dead face look that you had from like Heavy Rain and stuff like that. It's the realism is there quite a bit more.
The realism is definitely there for sure. And it doesn't waste time in jumping you right into the actual game itself. So we've seen that they are a tribal culture.
Yeah.
So it makes it feel like it's in the ancient past. But we soon discover they're actually not.
This is a futuristic game.
Down here! Rost! Rost! He won't hear me. Some kind of cave?
All right, so here we are. I am now controlling 6-year-old Aloy.
Well, 6 years later, Aloy.
Well, it starts when she's a baby.
So she is six then.
She is 6 years old, yes.
It's kind of scary with it. My daughter is six. Like, you know, the fact that, you know, and my daughter does enough things that she might be shunned one day, so she should probably play this as well.
So now we're seeing this, what they call the metal world, but it looks ancient. So
yeah, so it's all overgrown.
Yeah, and
said never go in places like this.
So we now have that instant wow, modern day. Our current modern day is what they consider ancient.
So this is sort of the Planet of the Apes sort of reveal that you know, they were on Earth all along, sort of thing.
Yeah. Which I love. I love that science fiction, you know, mixed with primitives.
Yeah, where it's a reset.
It's a reboot. It's humanity version 2.0.
Yeah, like everything, whatever humanity did before, they managed to screw it up so badly, it wiped everybody out, and this is everybody you know, restarting. Stuff like the 100 and even Battlestar Galactica did this.
There's something shiny there.
That guy's Bluetooth held up well.
Right?
Good battery life on that, too.
So you can turn on and off your focus. This is called the focus that she just picked up. And it basically highlights technology in your location or people, organics or machines, basically.
Okay, so it's like a Bluetooth sensor.
Closed. Maybe this device I found can help.
So it can, you can see it sees through walls.
It's connected to the door somehow.
And it comes in a lot handy a lot later, of course, when you want to scan enemies and find out their weaknesses and their strengths.
Yeah.
Color. It is your typical controls, you know, your camera controls. Everything feels natural when I play this game. There's nothing out of the ordinary.
That's good. I hate it when they try to implement some weird sort of camera control or something like that, and it just feels off.
Right. Now, this this symbol that you see just above her head right now, that is what you discover quite early on, is if you scan that with your focus, you now get... It's an audio data point.
Okay.
And you're listening to recordings that were recorded by... Well, the ancient ones, you know, who the people who lived in this place before it died.
So it unlocks some backstory for you, and that's basically your collectibles throughout the game?
That's part of your collectibles, and you're slowly learning kind of what happened.
Yeah.
Where did humanity go wrong?
Well, I mean, they're shunning people all the time. I mean, that's not good for them.
Well, that's not what happened in the ancient past, though.
This way? It's the best I can do. He's right behind you. Hi! Happy birthday, Isaac. Daddy sure does love his little big man. Look, Daddy can't be there with you and Mom, but we can still have a party, right? Sure we can.
Show me. Show me again.
I can do. He's right behind you.
Hi! Hi.
Happy birthday, Daddy Isaac. Sure does love his little big man. Look, Daddy can't be there with you and Mom, but we can still have a party, right? Sure we can.
You can see the effect the shunning has had on her, where she just wants to watch a happy birthday video from somebody who actually appreciates his child.
And, well, yes, but you know what I kind of really I like about that is the expression on her face was very, you knew exactly what she was feeling.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
So there's obviously places to discover. You can actually return to this place later on. You can get to locations that are out of the way.
So once you get find some more tools that help you unlock certain things.
Yeah, basically. You can then, when you're older, you can return and get to locations you can't get to right now.
Yeah.
How did they die here? What happened to them?
There's a few of these audio logs. I'm not going to collect all of them now for the case of the episode, but there's quite a few in here.
Yeah.
And it just gives you an idea of who these people are that you've now kind of stumbled across.
Come, girl. Take my hand. You don't belong down there. Come.
Is this her father, or is this just her protector?
Guardian.
Protector, okay.
Her guardian, yes.
They are of the metal world. What is that on your face?
Nothing.
Did you find it down there?
No.
Give it to me.
No.
Aloy, such things are dangerous.
No!
Well, if you're gonna go sneaking away from home, you'll need to know how to survive in the wild. Come, Aloy. Home now. Starting tomorrow, you will learn to hunt.
A little skip in her step there.
Yeah.
All of these cutscenes are actually in-game cutscenes. So as you get older and you get new armor.
Yeah.
That, however you're dressed, however you appear, is how you appear in the cutscenes. It's all in-engine cutscenes, which is really great.
Yeah, it doesn't take you out of that moment.
It doesn't take you out of the game, and there's no loading.
Yeah.
And enough muttering to that plaything. We descend to the valley now. Follow. The wilds can be dangerous, Aloy. You will need to stay close and do as I say.
I know.
Now, you're still scratched up from that fall you took yesterday. So let's start there. Take this medicine pouch. I'll show you how to fill it. See this plant over here? It's called Southbrush. Come, gather its berries in your pouch. Good. Now eat the berries.
I like when games give you a reason for there to be a HUD in the world, too.
Always keep your pouch full of medicinal berries, flowers, and plants.
Where are we?
This valley is just a part of All Mother's Embrace.
Embrace.
The Nora tribe watches these lands and keeps out the most dangerous machines. Usually.
Sorry, Jeff. Not right now.
Further downriver, we'll find a herd of machines, and I will teach you how to hunt.
Are they dangerous?
All machines are dangerous, Aloy. Their power must be respected. But I will be beside you. Aloy, machines coming. Crouch and follow me into the tall grass. There. Now stay low.
Little one.
No, Aloy. Such machines are called watchers. You must learn to avoid their gaze. If you are to survive in the wilds, I will show you. Listen close and do as I do. Stay still. Wait for it to pass. Now keep low and follow me across the trail to that tall grass. Oh, another one. Let it pass. This way. The slower you move, the quieter you'll be. And crouched walking is quieter than upright. Wait for it. That's the last of them. Let's move on. Did well. They didn't see or hear you. Now stay close. That herd should be just ahead.
Who's that?
Ignore him.
But why is he up there? He's smiling at us.
Teb! Get back where you belong! Teb! Where are you?
Ignore him. We are outcasts and he is of the tribe.
Maybe he doesn't like the tribe.
Then he is a fool. Come now. Let's find that herd. Follow.
Like, another thing I love about this game is just how absolutely lush the environment is.
Yeah, it's not like a desert wasteland or like gray and like there's green all over the place, which is really nice.
But a live green, like it's look, like, it's the grass is swaying in the breeze, like it just everything looks real.
Ha! Get!
It feels like it you know, like a real place. It feels like this is sort of like filmed on location in like the you know in Arizona or something like that.
Yeah,
they're best approached by stealth. Don't worry, we'll catch up with them further down the valley. You'll see. Now I want you to find some rocks that fit the cup of your hand.
Why?
Do as I say, Aloy, and gather the rocks. I will show you how to use them. Good. That's it. Those will do. Follow.
You're making a lot of noise.
It's because I'm running.
I know.
Running makes noise.
There's the herd. All right, it's time to throw some rocks.
But rocks can't hurt machines, right?
No, but they can distract them, draw them into traps. Like that watcher over there. It must be dealt with, or it will warn the herd and send them running before we get in range.
Warn them? How?
The machines speak to each other, Aloy. Unless they are first silenced. Now you stay here on the ridge. On my signal, throw rocks and draw the watcher over to me. Wait for my signal. Hey, throw a rock near me.
said stay on the ridge. Come, girl, you're not listening. Alright.
He just told me to come down.
You were already on your way.
Good. Now, gather stalks of ridgewood from the plants over there.
So this is essentially this whole beginning part is it's tutorial. Your, it's your tutorial.
Yeah.
But it does a good job kind of easing you into all the different things to do in the game, the things you need to do with stealth and how to
use
distraction rocks
and metal shards for arrowheads.
And then you can craft your
you'll never arrows if you know how
on the go.
What you need.
Just open up your wheel, you highlight the ammo you want, and you can instantly craft it by, as long as you have the items you need to craft.
I like that. I like that you don't have to be at a crafting table or something like that, because that's always a pain. Follow.
It's great, but it's also the one thing that's kind of a little bit unrealistic is if I'm running away from something, I can just craft arrows while I'm running. Really?
Here, stay low in the grass and be quiet.
Because it all goes into a pause when you're in that menu?
It slows down.
It's time to make your first kill, Aloy.
It doesn't pause, it slows down.
Strider, one of the weaker machines. But even a weak machine can kill a hunter if she's careless. You must study it.
So you're hunting these for not for food, because it's a machine.
But they will attack you if you don't.
Can you guess another?
Yeah. So that's Tyrant telling you that there's a weak spot on his back?
Yes, the blaze container is weak.
It's on its back. Is that a weak
hit? Keep firing!
Well, two shots to take him out.
You did well today, but you have much to learn. Tomorrow, we train.
Yeah, I assume you can upgrade your bow at certain points and stuff like that too.
You don't really upgrade the bow, but you can add modifications to your bow, to some of your bows, or you can buy better bows that are already more powerful. And then the better the bow, the more modification slots you have.
Okay. What about like finding stuff in the wild? Do you find a lot of equipment and weapons in the wild?
You find modifications, but all your weapons have to be purchased.
Okay.
So yeah, your loot drops are never going to be weapons. They're going to be weapon parts, or ammo parts, or weapon or armor modifications.
Okay.
Oops.
That guy fell down, and then all these machines want to eat him now?
They just want to play with him.
But they play rough?
Yeah. That's right.
I can do nothing. It's only a matter of time before the machines find that boy and kick him to death.
Just kick him to death.
It will cause a stampede, and it will trample him.
But I can see the path they take.
Stop telling stories.
I'm not. I can sneak through.
You will not. Aloy!
All he did was steal her bow.
Right?
It's entirely not helpful.
She reminds me of my girls. My girls are all redheaded with freckles.
Well, mine too. And pure evil.
So I can look at him and I can highlight the track he's taken.
Slowly.
So you know which way he's going and how long it's going to be until he's back in that spot.
Right.
can't let them see.
You know where, what eye line you have to avoid?
Well, I know the direction they're taking, basically, right? So I can kind of go around that. Didn't happen when I first played it.
You died.
I tried to run. I think when I first played the game, I was too afraid to run, so I didn't.
You probably should continue to be afraid, because look what happens.
You're right. I should absolutely be afraid to run. She's not as quiet as she is. I have better armor, which makes me quieter, so yeah.
Oh,
young so Aloy does not have that.
Yeah, I think you gotta wait for these things to turn their backs on you, too.
Almost there.
You gotta slowly make your way to the tall grass there.
Yes. Wait for him to pass by.
There he is.
So it's not really that he saw me, it's that he heard me running.
Yeah.
Can't see me.
And you can see at the top, underneath my radar, there's a straight line. That means I'm invisible. So I'm in stealth.
So he's going to walk back past.
And you can see now it's an eyeball, meaning I'm out in the open. I can be seen.
Yeah. The intercutting between gameplay and cinematic, story moments is really done smoothly.
It's really smooth. Yeah, it's done like that. It's like that throughout the whole game.
Yeah, that's excellent, because it really doesn't it doesn't take you out of it to bring you into a cutscene or anything like that.
No, and there's no pause between them whatsoever.
Yeah. From the turn and head back.
Here's what I love too is they do a really good job making you afraid of a watcher, which is literally the weakest creature in the entire game.
You are six.
Yes, I know. But they do a really good job kind of upgrading your confidence in the game.
Yeah.
You know, where if I come across a watcher in the full game now, late, 35 hours into the game, I can just walk right up to him and give him one hit and he's dead.
Yeah.
But here, you're afraid of them.
It is no plaything.
Wait. Oh, Mother, bless that girl. Bless you both.
Boy!
She saved me. I just want to...
Boy! Seal your lips. They are outcasts, both. And she is motherless. Come now. Back to Mother's heart.
That seems like, a mean thing to have pointed out.
Right?
That boy should not have spoken to us. It's against tribal law. We'll go home now. Follow.
I know the way.
Ooh, she's mad.
Yeah, sounds like my six-year-old.
Samuel.
now, Mother!
Now, here's a neat thing in the game, too, is you can choose if you want to confront, you want to use insight, or you want to have compassion. And it doesn't happen a lot in the game. There's a few times when you get to choose sort of the attitude in which you want to respond.
Yeah.
So I'm going to let you tell me what to do here, Tico. Should I aim for his head? Should I knock the rock from his hands? Or should I drop my rock?
Well, I usually play compassionate when I do this thing, so I would say drop the rock.
All right, let's drop the rock.
Stop!
I have a sense that kid's going to be a problem later on.
You're bleeding.
Yes, the look of, jackass,
here,
you know, chief.
I'll get it.
Yeah, pretty much.
Of the tribe leader or something like that.
Why am I an outcast?
Not quite, but Aloy, she does come across him again.
Not the time.
And that interaction comes into play.
I've told you.
Okay, what did you do the first time?
I knocked the rock from his hand.
You were just a newborn when the matriarchs brought you to me.
So the matriarchs, they know?
It's not so simple.
But they know.
Aloy, we are outcasts.
So how do I make them tell me?
The matriarchs? There is a way, perhaps.
So tell me.
It would be dangerous.
How?
It would take years of training.
I don't care. How do I do it? Tell me.
The proving. The tribe's rite of passage held every year. Those who pass become braves, but to the one who wins, the matriarchs grant a boon.
A boon?
Yes, whatever the winner wants.
Then I'll do it. Whatever it takes. I'll win the proving.
I see.
Another wonderful cinematic is going to come up here.
Started, then.
Yeah.
That honestly gave me goosebumps, being, you know, I am a father of three
Start training.
Redheads.
Yes. Follow.
It's basically a montage of her growing up, and it's fantastic.
It's the Rocky training video.
Yeah, kind of. There's a moment where she grows up, and it's great. It's just chilling. Yes, that move can actually be done in the game.
the slide under shoot?
Yes.
Nice.
There is a skill you can get that time slows down when you're jumping or sliding.
Rost?
So what do you think? That was definitely like a Rocky video, Rost? Right?
It really was. Like, you just expected her to, like, you know, jog up the steps, start pounding on some beef.
2 days
right?
Before approving and he goes off without me? He wouldn't do that.
I won't lie. I got emotional watching that.
They do a good job of, a lot of games don't do what they need to do to make you care about the character.
Right. So you can test your skills with the dummy here.
Let's get this over with.
Or I can use my bow. Just test the dummies. Or not test them, but you can practice on them.
Yeah.
He said we'd go hunting this morning. Why isn't he here? Where's he gone to?
So now we're on full-grown Aloy.
And open world, you know, sections of the world open.
So we now have this section of the world open, what I can see here.
Okay, that's
this is the,
pretty...
This, essentially, this is the beginning area. And I don't know how well you can see it on the video, but the map is three-dimensional. Like, you could, it's like an actual topographical map, right?
So if you zoom in, you'll actually be able to see the, you know, where there's, that's, I like that sort of thing in a map, because sometimes you're like going, it's like, you and you're like, oh, I just head straight there. It's like, oh, there's a giant mountain in between me and the area I want to get to.
Right. So, yeah, it's literally feels like it's the actual look down on the actual game world, which is really great. Gives you a sense of where the mountains are. You can see the hills and the mountains. So this is the starting area. It's pretty big, to be honest with you, okay?
Yeah.
When you first start the game, it feels like you're in this big world, but watch this. That's the whole map.
Wow.
That is your starting area compared to this entire world. It's pretty big.
It's a big game map.
Yes. And I'm only dealing with this map right now.
What's he doing up there? He's just standing there.
In my full game, I'm 35 hours in, and I've only seen... Maybe I'm at 50% of the map now?
Wow, so this is, you know, 70 to 90 hours.
Aloy.
I'm hearing it's about a 60-hour game. I'm probably halfway through.
Yeah.
Did you want to be alone?
No. We must speak. I've been thinking about your training, Aloy. You've learned to hunt, learned to survive. But I fear there's a lesson I failed to teach you. Would you learn it now?
Of course. I'll always learn what you have to teach.
There has been some trouble recently. It affords an opportunity to learn this lesson, but it will be dangerous. You must come prepared, or you will die. Descend into the embrace and hunt until you have gathered the parts for fire arrows.
Fire arrows? What kind of trouble are we talking about?
Once you have the parts, you will meet me there, at the gate beyond the village of Mother's Heart.
The North Gate? At the edge of the embrace?
Yes. Now be on your way.
Is something else bothering you?
No. I'm fine.
Are you worrying about what happens after the proving?
What happens is clear.
So like any good RPG, you know, like your Mass Effect, you have these interactions with characters throughout the game.
These stories to, again, make you care about the character and your task.
Right.
We will discuss this later.
Okay. Anything else you want me to do while I'm down in the embrace?
Odd Grotta might be out of food by now. You could hunt a week's worth of meat for her, if you find the time.
Wouldn't mind if she'd say thanks just once.
Grata follows the law. Her science towards us is honorable, not an insult.
If you say so. I'll go gather the parts, but I'm also going to pay Karst a visit.
Aloy, that man breaks the law every time he speaks to you.
And I'm glad he does. I want to buy a tripcaster, and no other trader will sell to outcasts.
Stock it with ammunition, then. You'll find use for that weapon tonight.
That sounds ominous. All right, see you at the North Gate.
Okay, so now if I go into my quests, this is where the quest log is.
Okay.
And I can see there's different, there's a main quest, right? So my main quest is, I have to pass the final skill test, which is gathering fire arrows.
Yeah.
I've also got an errand, which is to visit Old Grata. And I have no open tutorials. So you can see there's a bunch listed here that have been undiscovered so far. Those are different quest types that you'll get throughout the game.
Yeah, okay. So you have to find some stuff in order to unlock that.
Yeah, well, you have to discover the first quest of that type before it unlocks.
Yes. Yeah. Okay.
So whichever quest... You can only have one quest active at a time. Which I found actually a bit of a negative thing for this game is if you do something that will satisfy another quest, it doesn't actually satisfy it unless the quest is active.
Okay.
Which I find frustrating.
Like collect 10 of these things and you collect, you know, 20 of them and you know, and it doesn't carry them over.
Well, there is... Okay, so this is showing me where I need to go.
To that area?
There's a quest, for example. Let's take this as an example. If I go into my quests and I have... Oh, there's no tutorials. But if there was a tutorial quest in here that was like, use your new bow to kill 3 watchers, and it just teaches you how to use that new weapon you just got.
Right.
Well, if I use that weapon and go and do that anyway, it doesn't actually count towards the tutorial because the tutorial wasn't active at the time.
And because you can only have one active at a time, you can't do that one and take care of another.
There are other quests in the game called the Hunter's Lodge, where you're supposed to do three quests for the Hunter's Lodge before you can get in. You have to win certain trials. Well, I've won like 5 of those trials, but because I won them without having the quest active, it doesn't consider me having done it.
Oh. Are they redoable?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. I can go do it again. But I found that frustrating that I went to the Hunter's Lodge and said, oh, you have to do your 3 trials. And I'm like, I've done like 5 trials. And I realized it didn't count
because they weren't active.
Exactly.
Yeah.
2 days. 2 days until I get answers.
Okay, so
2 days and I'll know who she was and why I was cast out at birth. As if there could be an excuse for that.
So just traveling through the world now, trying to get to my location. There's 2 different locations I need to get to. As we can see, I need to trade for a tripcaster, and I need to gather blaze and gather metal shards. So blaze I would get off of striders. So let's go find some striders.
The fox looked a little weird.
I guess no one ever gets lonely in there.
Alright, let's figure out which one is which. That is hunting for blaze, so I'm gonna go to the left.
The closer one is the one to find your stuff first.
Alright, we're coming across some watchers here. And you can hunt this wildlife here as well. Like, there's a turkey.
Yeah.
So if I want, I can hunt that turkey.
Oh, you get plus 40.
I get 40 XP for it. And I also gather meat from it. Oh, crap. He saw me. All right. Is he searching? Let's...
Oh,
he's going to investigate his dead friend.
And he's you want to hit these guys in the head?
You want to hit them in the eye. That's their weak point.
Okay.
Just like that. And then you can gather stuff from them. So you can see there's a blue icon, which means there's going to be a rare item on him. And that is this machine core is a rare item you can use for trade or for crafting.
Okay.
All right, I'm getting metal shards from them.
You got three of the five?
Yeah, metal shards are your currency. But they're also used to craft arrowheads.
Right.
So you always want to do a save. I'm going to do a... I'll just do a quick save here. But you always want to save at the bonfires. And that,
that creates a fast travel, right?
It's a fast travel. It's also your restoration point if you die.
Okay. Yeah, you don't want to be going back too far.
Right. Okay, so here's the Strider area. I'll first want to get rid of these Watchers.
No, I noticed they have blue. Blue means that they have no idea that you're there now?
Correct. That's just their normal stance.
Yellow, okay, yellow is
yellow
searching.
Means they're searching. Red means they've seen you and they're about to attack.
Okay.
That wasn't a warning.
Alright, I need to get Blaze off of these guys, which is that canister on the back of them.
Okay.
Another nice thing too is if I want, I can scan them.
Yeah, and it'll tell you where it'll show you the weak spots.
I can also tag all those enemies, so if they go behind something, I can still see where they are.
Okay.
So that watcher's going behind the rock, but I can still see approximately where he is.
You know how long you have to wait. Oh, you spooked that one.
I did spook him. I need three blaze, so I might be okay.
You might get it from the other two that you killed?
Yeah. And with blaze and with the shards, I can create fire arrows.
Handy.
Now the health bar, if you look at the top left of the screen, you know, my total health, 230 of 230, but underneath that is a green line. That's sort of what I have in my storage. So if I need to heal, it comes out of that green bar.
Okay, so that's your herbs and medicine and stuff?
Yeah, so I basically have that much. If I needed to refill a full bar, I have enough to almost fill a whole bar.
Okay, so that's your medicine pouch.
So I only got one blaze. Well, that'll be another one. There's a blaze. So I have two blaze now, and there is another one right there.
Oh, I think the first one you hit.
Alright, now I have fire arrows. So now I can craft fire arrows. So this one weapon I have has two different arrow types. I can use a standard hunter arrow, or I can use a fire arrow. And you can switch between them at any time.
Yeah, okay. You're down to one arrow left.
Well, then how about I craft some?
Probably a good idea.
So like I said, even while I'm running, I can pull this up and see how the world doesn't slow down completely.
Yeah.
But I can craft while I'm running. Now, let's go get this tripcaster that I need. Feet away. Mr. Boar.
Now, will the regular wildlife attack you?
No, they'll all run away from you.
Okay. So they're smart.
They are smart. Yeah, boars don't attack. Rabbits certainly don't attack. Foxes, raccoons, turkeys. And I think there's geese.
Well, geese would attack.
You know, it's funny. I tried to hunt a geese. I don't think they're huntable.
No?
A goose.
A goose?
A goose.
Can't get your goose?
I am unable to get a goose. One more thing I want to show before we're coming to the end of this episode of OMG Its. But this game has a photo mode in it. Oh, of course. Camera controls currently unavailable.
Well, because we're sharing, I think.
Well, let's find out. Sometimes if you're near a city, it doesn't allow you to do that. Let's just try again. There we go. So I can pull my field. I can pan up and down. I can pan out and around. Right? You can create a photo. I mean, just look how beautiful this world is, seriously.
It's a breathtaking environment. Like, that's a, you know, desktop background
material right there. It is, absolutely. You can hide the UI. You can place a logo anywhere on the screen that you want. I chose to always put a logo down in the bottom right. It's just, I think it looks smart. Beautiful, beautiful game. But seriously, this, what you're seeing right now, this is just the starting area. I haven't even left this area. This area is surrounded by these mountains, but as far as I can see, if you can see it, you can travel to it.
Wow.
And it's
seamless too. Like, no, I don't, like, there's not been any ridiculous loading screens in between. No slowdown.
No, there's none. There are no loading screens. The only loading screens you'll ever get is if you're fast traveling from one location to another.
Wow.
Now, I do have to say, though, fast travel, you actually require a fast travel item in order to utilize it.
Okay, so there's currency for it?
You'll find fast travel. They kind of look like sleeping bags in your inventory. Yeah. But you need a fast travel in order to use it. Eventually, you'll be able to buy an unlimited fast travel, but just so you know, you can't just fast travel for no reason. It just doesn't work immediately.
They want you to explore the world.
Yeah. And to be honest, I do anyway. I rarely use my fast travel.
Well, well, well. An outcast on my doorstep. All mother protect me.
Surprised you saw me the way you keep looking every other direction to make sure no one's watching. Careful there, or you'll sprain your neck.
It's always a pain in the neck when you show up, girl, one way or another.
Is there a reason why you're acting so cranky today?
Once you run the proving and get made a brave, you'll deal with traitors and
every character
heart.
You come in contact
Maybe
with
I don't like losing
is
customers.
So unique. It's they traitors are characters.
Don't break the law.
They have personality.
They have personalities. Their
That's
look.
Right.
Everybody
will be behind it, us so long as you
there is no like
quiet.
A single look to every person. Everybody has their own very distinct look to them.
Are you worried I'm going to tell someone that you trade with outcasts?
I don't think you're the kind who talks. But you never know.
You can stop worrying. The secret's safe with me.
Yeah, that's what I figured. But I don't mind hearing it.
The only person I've ever told about our trades is Rost.
Yeah, well, not like he can turn me in, even if he wanted to. Law and duty sort of a man, that Rost. I don't know how you stand it.
You really don't know why he was cast out?
I've told you no. I don't think anyone knows what he did, but it must have been serious because his term is for life.
Why do you take the risk, trading with outcasts?
Every time you ask. If a big, meaningful talk is what you're after, move along.
It's because you used to be one, isn't it?
Yeah. Got caught poking around one of the metal ruins out beyond the Embrace. matriarch said I was tainted and gave me 5 years.
What did you see in the ruins?
Nothing I can make sense of. After my shunning, I tried living back in Mother's Heart, but everyone I knew had moved on, and there were so many people everywhere I turned. I like it better out here.
Last time I visited, you had a tripcaster available for trade. Still got it?
I do. But you'd need to bring me a scrapper lens. What can I say? Special weapons don't come cheap.
Oh, I can pay.
I think you have one of those.
Took down a scrapper not long ago.
Yep.
Stripped out the lens in perfect condition.
I'll be the judge of that. Show me.
All right, so now I can buy and sell. And again, here you have resources. You can sell any weapons if you have bought new ones. You can sell outfits. You get new outfits as you go. You have to purchase them. They're worth money plus resources. Modifications. So the modifications I have 6% damage, plus 6% tear, which are a damage type. Okay. And then there's traps and potions. Those are the items you can buy and sell. So I need to buy a tripcaster.
Yeah.
So I'm going to equip that into a slot. That slot corresponds to your D-pad.
Okay.
Sorry, so not your D-pad. Your weapon.
Wheel?
Wheel, yes, sorry. And there's usually free sample treasure boxes, so I usually take one of those.
No, why wouldn't you?
Now that you've got yourself a tripcaster, practice how to use it someplace else, all right? My life's exciting enough without a bunch of shock wire booby traps to trip over.
Really? Could have fooled me. Will you be around later, in case I want to make another trade?
I'll be here. Same as usual, bring me the parts you harvest from any machines you hunt. The better the parts, the more shards I'll pay. Be sure to take a close look at my inventory, though. Who knows? Maybe I've got something that could give you an edge in the proving.
I guess that concludes our business.
All right. Good luck in the proving. Blessing of all mother and all that.
I've got what I need. Time to meet Rost at the North Gate.
And now I've received a quest. If I wanted to go do it, I have a tutorial for the tripcaster. It'll teach you how to use the tripcaster. A tripcaster is basically a line that you can lay down across. You can then lure an enemy into it, and it shocks them. There's other different one. The one I have is a shock wire, so it basically shocks that creature, and then you can. I'll show you how it works here. So I lay down the line, and if I get an enemy to cross that line, it will shock them.
Okay, and so then, you just like set that up and then step out so a watcher can see you or something.
Yeah, or throw a rock or whistle. Eventually you can whistle to lure them in. You get a watcher or a strider or anything, and it will trip them, it will shock them, and then you can go in for the easy kill.
Okay.
Once it's laid down, though, it doesn't hurt you, but you can't pick it up again, so it's there for good.
Okay.
So that is how the tripcaster works. And I think that's, I think we should pretty much call it an hour there.
Yeah, that's exactly an hour, I think.
Pretty much. The first full hour of Horizon Zero Dawn. I'm absolutely loving this game completely. Like, you have no idea how much I love this game.
It looks very impressive, and this is actually a title I will probably pick up this week, and might actually get me away from the Xbox.
Wow, that's saying something right there.
Yeah.
So
I'm impressed. I'm impressed with this.
Guerrilla Games, thank you to Sony for providing this copy to review. I am in love with this game. I'm in love with the character, the world, everything about it. It feels good to play this game. You know what I mean? I said it on our podcast this week, Chico, which you were not available for, obviously, but this game has a lot in it, but it never overwhelms you with things to do.
Yeah. Right?
There's always something to do, but it's not like I have a quest log full of 100 things.
It looks like you get the sense of the quests sort of come as a natural progression as you're doing the game. It's not like it's like, oh man, I got to run all the way to the other side of the world to take care of this sort of thing. Like, no. The quests sort of are there, and they're handled as you would in a natural environment.
Yeah, that's absolutely a perfect way of describing it, Tico, because it is. As you are working on your main quest, you'll come across side quests that kind of happen. They may take you somewhere else, but it's always still towards other quests and your main quests. It never out of your way. It never takes you out of your way from the main story. And they all feel like it's part of this world and part of the events that are transpiring, which I obviously will not get into for spoiler reasons. But yes, the side quests are natural, and it's fantastic. So there you are, the first hour of Horizon Zero Dawn. I hope you enjoy the game as much as I do. I love it. Thanks again to Sony for providing this copy to us to review. Thanks for watching. We'll be back again next time.
Thanks, guys. Bye.
This has been an OMGNexus.com production.